since I left. Yeah, definitely feeling good to be here.
And he is targeting Russia 2018. He wants to get back into the Socceroos mix. Hasn't had a cap since 2014. Wayne Brown scored a stunner against the Melbourne Victory in the FFA Cup. See if he can produce now in the A-League. It is the champions who get the ball rolling here in the final game of the opening round of the Hyundai A-League season 2016-17. Here's Garuccio with the big switch, one of their off-season acquisitions. Now Thirio in the number 11 shirt. Good shout from Jack Duncan, a confident one to pull Bogart out of it. Not Duncan's first start in Newcastle colours. He made his first as an 18-year-old back in November 2011 off the bench for Ben Kennedy. And Kennedy's injury meant that Duncan starts the season as the number one. Now Enrique playing on the left. They made a bright start. Adelaide United, and unfortunate ricochet that falls for Duncan.
Well, he takes a chance. Kantorowski gets away with it. Bright start from Adelaide. Garuccio prominent in his opening minutes. Well, just past a minute. Two raids down the left-hand side.
Enrique looking bright. Thought that might have been offside there against Guardiola, who tried to find a return ball to the Brazilian. Strange to see Enrique not in the orange of Brisbane. Such a hero for them in those championship successes. The slippery fish, now a red.
It's strange to see him in anything other than the Brisbane raw colours, but it's a tremendous pickup. And I used a lot off the bench in Brisbane. We're starting here today. Just note the style, no Karuska as well as all those losses from that grand final side. So we know they like to play a possession-based game. Interesting to see. They've certainly started off brightly.
Wouldn't quite stick for Jugarkovic. Jets have it back through Bogart, though. Nick Calburn, the starting left back. And Andrew Hall has been on fire in pre-season. 7 goals in 6 pre-season games.
Well, it's a big season for Andrew Hall because he left here to join Sydney. There's many hopes that he would flourish there, and it didn't really work out.
Nice run through the middle from Jugarkovic, and it required the sweeping up from McGowan.
Yeah, good play from McGowan, but just on Hull, he'll have a lot to prove this season.
He's a Newcastle boy through and through, Andrew Hull. Expectation is that he will flourish back in his hometown. Play from Holland. A lovely feat from Isaias. Scored that wonderful free kick in the grand final against the Wanderers.
Yeah, and he's one of the key players, and lucky to have kept him. And he's the link between defence and attack, and always wants the ball, always looks forward, but certainly is capable to drop back. You see him there in the left fullback position, just rotating with Garuccio on the left.
And it's Holland in the centre circle where we're used to seeing Isaias do so much of his work. And that's come off the wrong part of the boot from Isaias, some early season rust. Only Corona had more touches than him in the A-League last season. Cool. This place pass that too much of Brown.
Oh, don't think he touched that either. In the boot. Saying that he didn't touch that ball. They'll get it now, but see him sliding in here, and there's no contact from him.
Much of contact off the head of Nabu that time either, but it worked its way through to Coco, who's trying to hem LaRocca in.
Yeah, it's good play from Coco because he does lose the ball there. I think it's an Adelaide throw, but what he does, he doesn't commit the foul. So even though it's an Adelaide throw, they keep them deep into their own territory.
Such a turnover for the champions. Jitte, Goodwin, Mork, Kamau, Pablo Sanchez, all departing. Karuska, an injury victim. Going to miss quite some time at the start of the campaign.
Newcastle will be very careful when they're in possession of this sort of area, particularly when they're attacking, when in transition, when they lose that ball. They've got a lot of speed in Thirio and Enrique.
Lovely pass from Elrich to Thirio. Enrique waits at the back post, and it's going to elude the slippery fish, a diminutive player. Not really his go to rise at the back post for the header.
God, they're lucky it was Enrique at the back post, because a terrific ball. Just dropped his shoulder, Thirio. Just clips this with bend on it to the back post, and Enrique was nowhere near it. Probably possibly just getting in a little bit early.
When you see the two wingers are going to be Thirio and Enrique, you'd expect them to be on the other sides, wouldn't you, from the start of this game? But perhaps fooling the Jets.
Well, we quite often see that. You know, they might change at any given time. Have noted, and we've talked a lot about Thirio, terrific action just moments ago, but most of his best work has come down that this left-hand side.
He had some dramas with a foot injury right at the start of pre-season, so it's great to see him right to go for round one. LaRocca, another who had that fractured cheekbone.
But you can see that tactic. They want to get the ball to the wide areas as quick as possible, Adelaide. That diagonal ball we became so accustomed to last season.
Jesse Macaroonis in the number 16 shirt. Another one tough to get used to in Adelaide United colours after seeing him so often as a substitute with the Melbourne Victory. SAS asking for more from Garuccio. The control of McGowan lets him down.
He just took his eye off it, but you know, for Newcastle, and Matt Thompson talked about, you know, a lot resting on their front four, and definitely is the case, and particularly against this side, because they haven't scored a goal against Adelaide in five matches, I think it is. I'm sure you've got the...
And last man to score for the Jets against Adelaide United was Geronimo, a former Red himself. You may remember it, a 2-1 win here at Hunter Stadium back in 2014. So it's the last time they've scored against Adelaide United. And they only scored 28 goals all of last season in their 27 home and away games. So they'll be looking for much better output under Mark Jones. Garkovic lays it off. Now Kandorowski dinks it in. Poole was in some space. Instead, there's a counter-attack on potentially for the visitors. Garkovic trying to hold up Thirio. Does so fairly effectively. Lovely first touch, allowed him to turn and try and release Guardiola. Good awareness from James Holland, able to keep Adelaide United in possession. See the midfield rotation evolving. SAS back in the central area now. Guardiola trying to Trying to slip that one through for Thirio. Mullen asks Duncan to come, and he sums it up pretty coolly and lets it come to him. Ruccio flying in.
Yeah.
And as we tick past 10 minutes, Robbie, it's a, you can hear the applause. Today would have been former Jet Bernardo Ribeiro's 27th birthday, but tragically he passed away back in May after collapsing during a match in Brazil. He played six games for Newcastle in the 2012-13 season and married a local girl, Katie, as well, who is in the stands today, and this must be so emotional for her. Jets fans remembering the one time number 10 at this appropriate time. There's Tarek Elrich, championship winner in 2008 as well, along with James Holland. So yes, Thirio trying to work the 1-2. Wonderful speed from Thirio. Blocked off at the pass by Bogard. Important intervention from the Jet skipper.
Well, he's the most likely at the moment. In the 12th minute, Thirio's looked very sharp and dangerous down that right-hand side. It's Cowboy in all sorts of problems, and it's a really good cover from the centre half. That's what you want your centre half to do, to help out the fullback, fullbacks, particularly when you've got two out and out wingers with the quality they have in Thirio and Enrique.
Garuccio whipping that one straight into Brown.
Has he got another corner? Or did they go for a throw?
Corner.
I'm not so sure.
I've got a different angle to you. From the commentary box, I say corner.
It's not much different from mine.
Not bad shape on this, but Duncan read it really well in flight. As McGowan was flying through the air. And Jason Hoffman trying to get it down the line to Naboo. And Enrique doing his defensive work.
Now here we go, Speedy.
Corner.
You are right. You love it when you're right.
You love conceding defeat. Calburn, that was great control off the chest. They work so hard, the wingers for Adelaide United, don't they? We saw Enrique on this side, and then Thirio just breaking the play up. Bogard, risky. Why would he play that ball straight to Enrique? Macaroonis, Guardiola, some deft touch, doesn't he, the number nine, on loan from Granada. He was on the bench at the start of the La Liga season before heading down under. Collins' ball almost cut out by Coco.
Well, they got away with that ball from Bogard, and they didn't really use that to their best. So a little bit lucky as Guardiola went to his right. Thirio still on the halfway line. He looks offside there. It's been a nervous start from the Newcastle Jets. Three or four unforced errors. I just wonder sometimes whether it's maybe better, maybe they're going to do it now. Push up to the halfway line. Hit a few longer balls rather than always trying to play up from the back and ask a few questions. And turn Adelaide around and play in their half at the very least.
Brown first to it. Nedeljkovic, who arrived midway through last season. Certainly impressed in his 11 games under Scott Miller. And Brown, combination play, but just too far out in front of Hoffman as he rotated with Nedeljkovic, allowing the right back to get forward and closing down. Oh my word! Coco, so close to the most extraordinary goal.
Oh, the crossbar saves Galekovic's blushes. He's just thinking, he's hesitating, taking far too much time.
Coco was a frequent scorer in the Finnish top flight, 56 goals in 97 games and nearly off the mark here.
Well, he just closes down and guesses that he might get there, and he's unlucky in the end that his block doesn't sneak in under the crossbar. Galekovic looking, you can see how worried he is, and gets away with it.
After all those clean sheets in the championship winning season as well, 12 of them for Eugene Galekovic. Nearly gifted one to the Finn. Now he's communicating with LaRocca and Garuccio. Neatly done by the former Melbourne City man. His good mate Stefan Mork took off midway through last season and won a championship with the Reds and then took off to Europe. They don't get to play together again in the City of Churches. Now Brown! Oh my word! The Englishman who scored a stunner against the Victory in the FFA Cup has now done it on the opening weekend again. What a strike for the Jets!
Well, that's a terrific hit from Wayne Brown, but he sets it up. And watch this. This bit of skill here just lifts it over two Adelaide players, hits it on the volley. Thank you very much. Across Galekovic. Watch this here. As the ball's coming to, one touch, lifts it over, hits it on the volley. Across Galekovic, no chance. That's a terrific goal from Wayne Brown. Absolutely top draw. Naboo nowhere to go. One, up, off he goes. One bounce in off the post. Really good strike from Wayne Brown.
He's the fifth Englishman to play for Newcastle, and some famous names before him. Emil Heskey, Michael Bridges and Franny Jeffers, but they'd all be proud with a goal like that from the man who played once in the English Premier League. That was at Old Trafford, off the bench against Cristiano Ronaldo and company. Thirio trying to answer, but never testing Duncan. So that recruitment drive through Finland paying some dividends. That's where Wayne Brown has spent the last four seasons as well, in the Finnish top flight. And Coco also came from, and they both look lively. Now Hull to Brown, the man of the moment. Hull right through the middle, opening up an angle for a pass. Naboo finds him, and Galekovic denies them a second. Incredible save, and brilliant build-up again from the home team.
Well, it's a great save from Galekovic. Probably knew not much about it, but he spreads himself, and Hull should have scored. A terrific run from Hull, who started the move, actually. Great ball in from Naboo. The surge was from Wayne Brown, and should have been 2-0. Galekovic just spreading himself, as he does so well. But really, Hull should have taken him out of the equation.
Remains on just one A-League goal. It was at that end for Newcastle against Sydney FC from the penalty spot. One goal in 65 A-League games, and should have had his second there. Mark Jones must be absolutely delighted with how his team has sprung to life in the last 5 minutes or so.
That's the ball from Brown. It was perfectly weighted for Naboo. First time across. On a plate for Hull. Credit Galekovic as well. He just made himself big. And there was no Newcastle player following through. They just sprang to life in the last 3 or 4 minutes. Got one, could have had two.
their new owner. Also here today, Martin Lee, Chinese ownership now for the Jets, after picking up the license from the FFA in the off-season. Already put their stamp on the club with the change of coach a fortnight ago. Scott Miller out, Mark Jones in. Plenty of time for Duncan to come and claim. No one in particular. McGowan gets the Reds on the front foot. Macaroon is ambitious, trying to find a path through for Theria. Naboo. Neat turn away from Garuccio, and Brown so busy again. Advantage not accruing. He's going to come back for the foul.
Yeah, good refereeing. Waited to see if there was going to be any advantage. A little smart little turn from Naboo. Another one with a lot to prove as well. We remember him from that famous comeback at Sydney Football Stadium. He came off the bench, didn't he?
Yep, scored a couple in a 3-2 win against the Sky Blues. So the free kick won by the goal scorer, Wayne Brown, and Andrew Hull trying to pinch too many metres for Alan Milner's liking.
Oh, he only went back half a metre.
Exactly. Net gain of about 2.5. Oh, whips it in.
Well, deserve someone attacking that. That's a really good ball in from Andrew Hull.
Well, hook clear by Holland. Guardiola asking for support as he pushes in on Duncan. Good climb by Garuccio. Now Isaias getting on the front foot. Left back is onside. Nice ball in. Macaroonis.
I'm not sure whether the pace he hits it with, the power, you'd think that was a shot, but it bent away like he was trying to cross it. I think it's called in two minds, but I'd have to say that was a shot. Good play from Garuccio. Looks to whip this one, and no one in there, and he sees a little run from Macaroonis. He gets himself into a good position, and really it's a rush of blood.
See Guardiola saying, just roll it around the corner and I'll have a tap in. Here's Brown again. Naboo stayed onside. Hall wants it in the middle. And Jugarkovic trying to place it in the top corner.
Oh, he takes it too early. Wrong option there. He had better to take that ball there. Two on two. Coco had pulled out to the left. So here you got Coco there. He's got Wayne Brown on his right. Newcastle looking dangerous on the counter.
What do you make of this setup as well from the goal kick? They want to make Galekovic go long, and eventually they've managed to achieve that.
And we know Adelaide don't like to do that, and that's what you're trying to do, get the second ball, and it's worked, and they use it.
Blustery day. Ball just hanging in the air a long time. Hoffman able to bring it down for his teammates. Nick, little trick from Coco. Now Brown, what about that vision? Try and pick out Hall, who kept his feet. Got the better of Elrich initially. Across to the back post, Naboo back across the face. They're looking lively and really dangerous in the final third, the Jets, which the home fans must be loving.
Yeah, and that one that comes across from Naboo, no one really going in for that, but good play. Hall on the back post. Clever ball from Brown over the top. Foul from Hoffman on Rike. Too strong that challenge, but pressure's been put on the front four and certainly looking dangerous up until this point. Already got a goal and really on the counter, looking very, very threatening.
Milos Trifunovic or Enver Alibidic for the Jets, who were so often on the team sheet last season. A lot of the recruitment done by Scott Miller. I wonder if he's watching on today, checking on his old charges. Wouldn't be surprised if Scott Miller might wind up in Europe with a job very soon, Robbie.
You got your spies out there?
Yeah, maybe Scandinavia. Watch this space.
Finland.
Finland, you're tipping. He's got some connections there, doesn't he?
I've heard that same one. Trying to get a foul. Referee Milner having none of it.
So yes, saw the move being made by Thurio. So did Calburn, though. Good athletic clearance. Enrique, no way past Ben Kandorowski. Charged down by the slippery fish and Guardiola.
Well, he gets away with it, doesn't he, Jason Hoffman? Allowing the ball to bounce and Guardiola not happy.
Not happy either with what's going on in the shopping malls of Adelaide. In the paper today back home, a lovely photo of him and his girlfriend, Susanna, who obviously do a bit of dancing during the week as well. But they're saying, why do all the malls close at 5:30 in Adelaide? We're used to going out beyond back home in Spain.
That's what I say about foreign players, you know, it takes them a time to adjust. The city of churches.
Got to wait for the festive period when we get that 24-hour shopping going. They'll be in heaven.
Well, we should note that it's not only Adelaide where malls shut at 5:30.
Got him for the whole season on loan from Granada. He was signed for Barcelona to play for the B side last year. But social media can catch you out, Robbie. And they trawled back through his tweets and found some offensive tweets about the Barcelona club. And he was quickly off the books. Enrique, did he bring this one down? Not a bad attempt. And then he looked like he'd fouled Hoffman, but it's play on.
No, I'm with the referee there. I think Hoffman just fell over.
Yeah, there weren't too many complaints from the right back.
Jason Hoffman stayed down, didn't he? Looking for the free kick. Coco's got to do better there.
Yeah.
Come to meet that ball.
And the rocker it was instead who got there first. Could have been another Guardiola on the books of Barcelona, where Pep was a superstar in midfield.
See how he has that. Gets up and he's always looking for that diagonal. Jakic won that ball and he's got Thurio regain it.
Here we are. Low. Giving Guardiola a sniff. It's well defended by Mullen. And now they break away. Trying to play the advantage is Milner, who had three or four goes at chomping on the whistle. Oh, how's the feet? We say yes. Got a free kick there for the tug on the shirt. It was dazzling footwork initially.
Well, again, Thurio, that threat. Ball takes too long. Another unforced error from Newcastle.
Enrique sniffing around and a tap in, surely. Macarunas makes no mistake. He rolls it in from outside the area and the champions draw level thanks to their former victory man.
Well, talk about gifting goals. I mean, there's three mistakes in this goal. First, they give the ball away. It was Hull attempting a long ball that was cut out. And this is just comical. I mean, you could see this ball was never going to get to there, and they've just got to deal with it. And then, for some reason, Duncan slides in and tackles his own player. Adelaide are good enough to score goals on their own without gifting them. Mullen goes away, and then, for some reason, Duncan goes with the follow-through. And Macarunas, credit him, kept his composure, strokes it home into an empty net.
Never scored in 40 appearances for the Melbourne Victory, and now on debut for the Reds. He scored within half an hour. he'll send thank you cards to a few Adelaide Newcastle Jets players for the gift. It was looking so promising for the home team with that lead that they may well have built on through Andrew Hall. Instead, we're level after half an hour. Space, but Ulrich with a quicker turn of speed. Being nudged by Guardiola.
James Holland asking why he didn't get a foul with the action just before.
Burn was out there. Wants the return ball from Hall. Just overhit though by the number seven.
No, right idea, just the execution. Haven't seen too much of Cowburn getting down that left-hand side, and he was certainly in for that one. Too much weight on the pass from Hall.
He's a player that's shown glimpses though when he's been given his opportunity. Prefers to play in midfield, but when he's played in the fullback roles, he's proved more than adequate. Might be able to lock down that position in this campaign. Guardiola certainly puts himself about. And the turnover nearly came for Macaroonis again. Not often you say it's a tap-in from outside the area, Robbie. That's what presented itself. There was no one between him and the goal. Just had to side foot at home.
No, but you still got to keep your composure. And that's exactly what he did. Mark Jones will be absolutely filthy with a gift like that.
Coco to control with Hall coming across his line of vision.
Well, Hill sometimes got to keep his width. There's no need really for him to come in there, and he hadn't really got in Coco's way there. Coco controls that. He needs an option to his left-hand side. Adelaide's still scoring really in control now.
First game one.
Possession.
Won't stick for Guardiola. Away goes Naboo. A surging run through the middle as well. Andrew Naboo opened up this space for Brown. Now Hoffman overlapping. And that's a bonus. Free kick for the Jets.
It's a really good result for them, wasn't it? Just that, not sure if he took a knock, Coco, but as a play was developing, he sort of just stood in the same position, didn't make any kind of run forward. Bill took a Hull took a free kick from this position before, which was a dangerous one. He's been relieved of that duty for Garkovic to take this one. Decent position.
SAE is still debating the decision. ball standing in an offside position for a moment. There's a jet down. Ambitious prize for a penalty with Coco hitting the deck. I think she was being manhandled by LaRocca.
He's limping, Coco, isn't he?
Yep, he's asking to come off, I think.
That was in that last action when they streamed forward and he just stood still, didn't offer any run. This will be a change.
You don't want to lose your number nine on the opening weekend of the season inside 40 minutes, but that's what the Jets are facing here.
Devante Clute. It's the option for me looking at their bench. He's the one getting ready.
It's the end of the section for the Soviet-born Finn. Two-time top scorer in the Finnish top flight in 08 and 2015. But here comes Devante Clute. And didn't get much game time at the Brisbane Roar under John Aloisi, but he's going to get a whole lot more here in the Hunter.
I was a bit surprised he wasn't in the starting 11. He gets a chance very early on.
There's the championship-winning coach from 2008. Now the Matildas assistant coach, Gary Van Egmont. It'll be quite the reunion tonight, I reckon, Robbie, around this part of the world. Reminiscing about 08. Here's Enrique. What a move. And well read in the middle by Bogart.
Oh, he's got Hoffman backing away. He's so effective one-on-one, Enrique. And once you get your defender square like that backing away, he's always going to be able to eliminate it.
Now Garuccio into the area. And Bogart has to be on location again. Guardiola just can't get goal side of him for a tap-in. He's had a few opportunities. If he can make the right run.
Well, if you look at that one, if he had it checked and gave Garuccio the option to cut it back rather than going for that near post, Bogart had it covered.
Garuccio's out there for the short corner if required, but it's going to be whipped in straight away by Makarunas, and Duncan just flung out the left hand in the end and got lucky.
Well, very lucky. He should be coming for that ball anyway. He didn't want to come for it. And in the end, he's very lucky that no Adelaide player gambled. Normally, you see a player on the goalkeeper. Would have had a tap in there. Very nervous from Jack Duncan.
Clute getting involved. Substitute waits for a delivery from Naboo. That's over hit for the diminutive Clute in the middle.
Well, Naboo goes too early. Needs to take on his defender there, but he's a little combination, Garuccio and Enrique. Now what's the run of Guardiola? Well, I suppose even if he checks off, there is a Jets player there, but maybe for Garuccio there was one a little bit further back. But sometimes you just got to put your hand up and say, well, that's decent defending from Bogart.
Duncan has spent some time with the Perth Glory and also in Denmark with Randers. He's got a good chance to try and nail down this number one shirt, mind you, as Daniel Garr mentioned pre-game. Ante Kovic is here today for those celebrations from 2008, and he looks likely to sign, you'd think, with the Jets looking for a club, the veteran.
Well, it hasn't been a fantastic first half for Jack Duncan. I mean, you really have to point to him at fault for the goal. He follows through, only knows why, and tackles his own player, Mullen, who was in control of that ball.
Maybe Isaias or Garuccio, it's the Spaniard. Doesn't get a pass, Kandarovski. Or Bogart second time around. Kept alive by Makarunas, who's making a really impressive debut. Adelaide United. Again, they get in a bit of a muddle and get away with it. Bogart hitting it off the back of Kandarovski. like a team who could do with a bit of a team talk and get back on the same page.
Yeah, they just look nervous, undecided at times. And it's been a patchy first half for them. They've looked really good at times going forward. Should have had a second goal through Hull. Defensively, taking a lot of risks, and they've paid for some of them.
Nice range on that pass from James Holland, who knew he was hitting it into the breeze, and it would hang up for Guardiola, who wins the corner. Moral support, the left footer. Macaroonis again deep this time. And there was some push and shove spotted. Given against LaRocca, who was in a tangle with Bogart.
Yeah, Duncan just sending Mullen and Bogart up towards halfway line. I think that's... they need to do at the moment, Newcastle. At times they've had difficulty playing out from the back. Looked dangerous when they got off the ball further forward, but been able to do that enough.
Mullen had to move that on in a hurry. The pressure from Thiria so effectively. The former Reds in the heart of the defence. For the Jets, is Clute somehow got it past Enrique. Now Brown, Hoffman out where Naboo's been whipping in his fair share of balls so far. Forced all the way back into their own half.
Yeah, they just sliding across that. Adelaide midfield did well there to force Newcastle back.
In their run to the championship, the organisation under Guillermo Amor. So hard to break down, the stingiest defence all of last season. Picked alive nicely there by Hoffman. Now Clute, never afraid to shoot, and just didn't have the angle that time.
Yeah, he had to take it quick as well, didn't he? Decent first touch and then just slices it. But he does, and he's not shy of taking the strike on. Hull cutting inside. Decent first touch and then he had to take it really quickly as he's closed down. And that Mark Jones, I can see exactly what he's saying. He's telling Andrew Hull to get at him.
Look at the way that goal kick from Galekovic hung up. Didn't even get to the halfway line. Clute already directing traffic. Saying, give it to me and get moving, Andrew Hull. Lovely touch from Clute, and now he does release the one-time Sydney FC man. And that's a bonus corner because it wasn't convincing from Andrew Hull. That's what you get from Devontae Clute, though. He's a young man, but he's not afraid to give directions out there. Football brain.
Look, it's a shame, and we hope it's not too bad an injury for Coco, but I think it's actually maybe a positive that Clute's come on for Newcastle, because he wants the ball and he's confident on the ball.
Cool. Good delivery. It gave them a chance through.
That's a free header for Mullen.
Yeah.
Completely missed it. Just glanced off his fringe. Flat ball in from Hull. You can see his hands went straight to his head. It's a decent chance that.
Again, they've got space out on this right-hand side. It's been at their mercy throughout the game. Clute bouncing one off Hull and now finding a path through. That's beautiful play from Clute. And it's cut out by LaRocca, importantly.
Well, you see the intelligent positions he picks up, Clue. And he always wants the ball, and he wants to play forward. And it's been periods in this first half when Newcastle players have always played backwards. Terrific little 1-2 with Hull, and Mabu with trying to find Brown in the middle.
Clue just lost the boot there, but the Jets win a corner.
Well, Clue needs his boot. Can't have a
poetry.
You can't have a bootless Clue.
He's already got a highlight reel that's the envy of many a player. Some of the goals that he scored for the Brisbane Roar in the Asian Champions League and the A-League. He waits on the edge of the area here as Hall whips in another one. Chance in the middle. In great goalkeeping by Galekovic again to get it clear of the danger zone.
That's two really good corners. Two good deliveries from Andrew Hull. And Adelaide defended that well. That's a wicked ball into the box. And actually, Galekovic does really well to parry that away.
A very watchable first half. And a spectacular goal. Opened the scoring from Wayne Brown. But then an equaliser from Jesse Makarounis, who capitalised on a massive mistake at the back from Jack Duncan in the Newcastle goal. So at half-time here in the Hunter, it's Newcastle 1, Adelaide United 1. And we can go down to Daniel Garb.